As you can see, I'm constantly working on new electronics projects, which oftentimes requires quite a bit of soldering. What I love to do most while soldering is listening to music. And no, this video is not sponsored by some wireless earplugs. But anyway, while listening to music, I pretty much always miss the doorbell, which is a huge problem for me because most of the time there is a postman at the door trying to deliver the components for the next projects. And since I live in an apartment house, which obviously houses several families and whose intercommunication system is all connected together, I cannot simply rip out my old intercom and replace it with something smart that could talk to my phone. Instead, I need to find another solution, something small and inconspicuous that I can add next to my intercom so that my landlord doesn't get angry and that sends push notifications to my smartphone immediately through WhatsApp or similar as soon as someone rings the door. So in this video, I will try to build something just like that. And since I know that not everyone is super excited about doorbells, let me tell you right now that such a system is also great for all kinds of alarms and triggers that require super fast push notifications. Let's get started! This video is sponsored by Altium and their Altium Designer software that you can try out for free to create some stunning schematics and PCBs. Now, their software also comes with Altium 365 integrated, which basically connects your designs with a cloud storage so that you can easily share and get feedback on your designs to increase your productivity, which is pretty awesome. So like I said, feel free to try it out for free by clicking the link in the description. First off, I thought about a theoretical plan for this project, and as it turns out, it was pretty straightforward. Step 1 is to inspect the intercom system and find a point in the circuit that changes its voltage level when the doorbell rings. Step 2 is then creating an ESP8266 microcontroller based electronics thingy that as soon as it detects the voltage change, sends a push notification through Wi-Fi and the internet to my smartphone, which will hopefully appear on WhatsApp, because yes, that is the messenger I use the most. And last but not least, I will have to see how I will power the new electronics through the intercom and house it all. But all in all, like I said, this plan seemed super straightforward. So let's start off by having a closer look at the intercom, which like many others, comes with a speaker, microphone and door opener button. But we do not really care about the exterior right now, which is why next I simply removed the front cover and was greeted with a small control PCB, which is only connected through 4 wires to the intercommunication system. The left 2 wires are for the twin bus system, which is mentioned on the PCB, and the other 2 wires are for the bell ring button on my floor. I know this because there is a 260-page manual about such twin bus systems, which are apparently nowadays still quite popular, and like the name implies, use a data bus for communication between the intercoms in the apartments, the bell button panel at the main door, and the main control system in the basement. So yeah, since they're using a data bus whose composition is not available for the public, I would have a hard time decoding that, and finding out which data bits mean that my doorbell rings. But luckily, there are other smart people out there on the internet who partly reverse engineered the intercom's PCB in order to find out the function of these other pins here. And in case you're wondering why I taped a magnet in front of the PCB, then let me tell you that it simulates that the telephone part of the intercom is still in place. But anyway, most important are these pins right here, which are ground and right next to it my desired ring signal. As you can see, this pin is usually at ground level, but if someone rings the door, the voltage rises to 5 volts afterwards, which is exactly the indicator I was looking for. That means next it was time for step 2, by finding out how to send WhatsApp notifications to my smartphone with this ESP8266 board that you can get for cheap from the internet. And if you're thinking right now, why don't simply integrate this ESP board into my Home Assistant system, which at the moment consists of a Raspberry Pi server, one ESP for door alarm, and one ESP for security camera, then let me tell you that those push notifications are sometimes a bit sluggish depending on how my smartphone is currently feeling. And in case I completely confused you right now, then feel free to check out my home security / automation series with Home Assistant. But anyway, I want my doorbell alarm system to be like this, super snappy. So I searched the internet on how to send to the WhatsApp service with an ESP. And I basically found two services that can do that, called Twilio and KomiBot. Now Twilio required me to create an account, and already at first sight looked a bit more complicated. But after a bit of trying around, I was able to send WhatsApp messages, which, like I hoped for, was super quick. But it seems like it was costing me a bit of money. So because of that and the complexity of the service, I decided against using it. Now KomiBot on the other hand was very easy to use and doesn't even require creating an account. By messaging it, you basically get an API that you can then directly use in the Arduino ESP codes. And as you can see, according to this simple demo circuit with a push button, it seems to work perfectly fine, at least at first sight. The problem was that it took sometimes between 10 to 20 seconds to send a message, and by that time, my postman at the door would be gone. So sadly, this method does not work as well for me, which is why next I looked for alternatives and found this universal Telegram bot library created by Brian Liu, who's also an electronics YouTuber. To use it, all I had to do was to install Telegram on my phone, talk to the bot father in order to create my own bot that also gave me an API, then get my Telegram ID from the ID bot, and ultimately use those two information in the given ESP example code here in order to send out a Telegram message with a push of a button. And as you can see, this method works way faster without having to register anywhere besides Telegram. So it is a winner for me. That means it was time to merge the ESP with my intercom. And to do that, I firstly added a voltage divider to the ESP that converts the 5 volts of the intercom to 3.3 volts that the ESP can handle. After then creating the final codes and uploading it to the ESP, I thought about how to power it next to the intercom, and remembered that there was actually 24 volts DC available at the pin next to the ring contacts, which reminded me of a certain meme. But after a moment of clarity and checking in my basement to see the power supply for the intercom system, I realized that it can only provide 34.5 volts ampere. The ESP though requires around 80 milliamps normally or 250 milliamps peak, which in my opinion is a bit too much of an extra load for the intercommunication system to handle. I mean, like I said, I do not want to interfere with the function of the system and thus possibly annoy other families in this house. But luckily, I had a 5-volt power supply already very close position to my intercom, which I only used so far to power my door alarm system. So all I had to do to use its power for the new ESP as well was cutting its USB wire and basically splitting it into the already existing one and one additional one. And that means it was time to finish this project, which I did by connecting the intercom PCB pins with the ESP, designing a small enclosure, 3D printing that, reinstalling the intercom PCB, adding a cable duct to my wall, adding the enclosure next to the intercom with the help of Velcro tape, soldering the power wires to the ESP, and finally closing everything up. And just like that, this project was complete. And as you can see, as soon as the door rings, I get my Telegram message pretty quickly, which means I will hopefully never miss the doorbell again. With that being said, I hope you enjoyed this project and maybe learned something new along the way. If so, consider supporting me through Patreon. Don't forget to like, share, subscribe, and hit the notification bell. stay creative, and I will see you next time.